Joe's in the hospital.
Joe?
No, Joe.
Joe who?
Joe Green.
No kid.
What is it, Chief?
Joe Green is in the hospital.
Yeah, I was just telling you.
I read it.
Yeah, too bad.
Too bad it wasn't fatal. It could have been with the right kind of workman. So now.
I've got to make a telephone. I've got to telephone.
Mr. Green, you can't phone anyone. Doctor's orders.
I must. I tell you, just once.
Green, you're a very sick man.
Oh, I promise to obey all your orders from now on. If you'll just let me talk to Johnny Cave. I must, I tell you, it's urgent.
Very well. Just this one call, but no more. Plug in the telephone for Mr. Green. Department of Weights and Measures. Oh, yes, Mr. Green. No, Mr. Green. I'm positive he isn't in because there was a call from Mr. Cave just a minute ago from the city prosecutor. Yes, Mr. Green. As soon as he comes in, I'll tell him you want him. Yes, I will. And take care of yourself. And don't worry. Hello? Have you located Mr. Cave? Well, please keep trying. I'll call back later. Where is Mr. Green, please? 212, second floor. Thank you. Dr. Richards, please. First one to your right, third door. Information desk. Yes, Dr. Richards, she's on her way up now.
Pardon me, I'd like to see Joe Green, please.
Sorry, but Mr. Green is not permitted to have visitors.
Well, would you please have Johnny Cave called?
Mr. Cave? Oh, I've been trying everywhere, Mr. Cave. Please go right up. Mr. Green is in room 612.
612? Thank you.
So, just another order. I'm telling you, Johnny, I'm staying. Was crossing the contracts. Suddenly, the automobile ahead of us stopped. Again on the brakes. The machine ahead started away just as the streetcar hit. When I came to, I recalled the case. One of the men in the car ahead looked back just before the crash.
You recognize him?
I think it was again.
Cavanaugh's?
Yeah. Marty Cavanaugh's.
I never met that mother. And I'm going to make it my business to before long.
You're no longer from the professor. Remember, you're in the Department of Weights and Measures.
I'd like to take his measure.
I'm giving you a chance. But the department wants evidence, not problems.
I told you I'll be here for weeks.
I'm going to make you chief deputy.
Me?
Yeah. In my place. I know I can depend on you, John.
Thanks, Mr. Green. Glad you think so.
Remember now, keep your head on your shoulders and your fists in your pockets.
Yeah, I'll be so.
This Cavanaugh's 20 acres.
Let me take all the bite out of him. And now trouble will be over, huh?
Cavanaugh's just a preliminary. The main bout's yet to come. It's someone higher up.
Well,
his time is up, Mr. Green.
I'll just leave
it. Now? Now, remember, Johnny. Don't let that fist rest against anybody's chin.
Oh, don't worry. It won't. You should be able to play that next time I see you.
Good word, sir.
Me. Don't be late.
No, I just had to say, I'm going to be
I'm just pinch hitting for Joe Green while he's in the hospital. Now, you know, without my mentioning any names, who put him there. And why? Because he wouldn't take orders from anybody except people who trusted him. He knew what it meant to cheat the housewife. Of course, it doesn't sound like much, chiseling just a few ounces of meat on the pound or a few potatoes out of a sack. But understand this. 40% of the American income is spent on food. And if people are cheated out of only 5%, in 1 year, that adds up to more than the war debt. Now, it's a big job. A big racket, by the way. People on the other side of the fence have a great deal at stake. And they want to make it very tough for them. So if there are any of you who are a little bit afraid to tackle it, now's the time to fall. Thanks. That makes it unanimous. Now, here's a neat little gadget. And one of the latest. Here we have a 2 pound weight. Put on the scale. It still weighs 2 pounds. Watch the hand. But very tough on the housewife. And you'd be surprised. The name of some of the stores is still probably boosted to advantage. Very delicate point. Practically every time you make a pinch, you're going to be offered a bribe. Now, some deputies have taken bribes. That's your answer?
All right, boys.
I'm calling the Hawks and Barnes. Take a shot, Captain Tanner. A few hearts, yes, sir. There's one left for you. You may.
Show me around.
Okay, pal.
Now, you were late.
That I was. I am not disputing you. I was late. But do you know where I was? I was around to all the newspapers to see if they knew that you were the new chief deputy.
Mm-hmm. Where are you from?
Well, I was born on the Great Blasket Island off the southwest coast of Ireland. But I live most of my boyhood in a little bit of a village outside of Foxburn, County of Mayo.
Mm-hmm. Not the type of the kosher markets. I think I'm going to take you myself. Well, if you don't mind, I'll just go on your own wishes.
Yeah.
And this is it. A lot of complaints about this one.
I wish I think I'd buy some strawberries. How much are they?
25 cents.
Mm-hmm.
Are they fresh?
Fresh, and every berry is big for a size.
Mm-hmm. Take a box.
Yes.
You know, there's a saying in Ireland that it's all right to pick the berries, but you must never, never cut down the vines, because under the vines live all the good fairy. And if you cut down the vines, you do away with their power to do good for you. Huh?
That's very interesting. But there are no strawberries in Ireland.
Oh, no, I could swear I saw some of the country fair.
I think I'll buy 5 pounds of sugar. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
5 pounds of sugar, please.
Right.
How much is that?
8 cents.
You are even mine. Well, Aloysius, what do you want for supper?
Oh, I don't know. Something that would stick to you. I've got an appetite for corned beef.
And I've got a reason for chicken. How about a nice stewing chicken? About 6 pounds.
Okay. There you are, 6 pounds right on the head. Wrap it up. Let me see it.
Nothing in there.
And just laid it.
Get home.
Sorry, what's the idea? You can. Oh, Miss Breedy, Miss Breedy.
Mmm. Very cute. Both in the sawdust make no noise at all.
Not bad, not bad.
What is it? What is it?
Poison.
How do you suppose those got there?
Your guess is as good as mine. Let me have that sugar.
Hmm? 4 1/4 pounds. I paid for
it. Well, I can't understand, Pat.
We must do our best to help you. Let's do it.
You haven't missed any bets, have you?
How about buying that bird back for $50?
Oh, it'll be a waste of money.
He spoiled by the time he got out of jail. Hold on a minute, I wish he had evidence.
And not leave my hands.
Give me that chicken.
First time in your life, Nia. Now hold on to that. And another move out of you and I'll pin your ears back.
Yes, sir. Fill it up.
Five. Yes, sir.
Did I never tell you about the giant causeway? There were big giants in the island, so big, they stood on the top of mountains and they threw hills at each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was the leprechaun. Little people, no bigger than your tongue, and you could see them walking around.
Mm-hmm. And my grandmother used to tell me about Lucifer the devil, who had one big knee and one little knee. You ever seen that?
How many is that time?
Thought so. That'll be 93. This is a company call. I need a receipt.
Okay, just a minute.
It's our last job before lunch. I've got to take my girl.
Take her to the Echo Cafeteria. It's a new
show. Oh, not a chance to go to the Ritz today. This is a celebration. An event.
Oh, I see.
What should you have in there?
Not a drop. Car's tank is about inside. You want to run out, and you have to pay your 5 gallons.
Oh.
That's what I thought. A little over 4 gallons. Why, thanks. You were warned about this violation last summer. Now you draw a summons.
Oh, wait a minute, fellas. Wait a minute. Listen. Can I give you the fine and save me the trouble of going downtown? Oh, come on, what about $20?
I'll save what you need for the fine. Put a tag on that for the corner.
Oh, goddamn.
Why, you...
Did you break your hand?
Oh, no. Thomas.
Check for $1,000 to the midnight mission. Made it right away.
Thanks again, Mr. Kelly.
Well, not at all. My pleasure. Goodbye, Mr. Marvin.
Oh, Mr. Kelly, would it be all right if I attended this after lunch? I have a date with my boyfriend.
Of course.
Oh.
Run along. Check and wait.
Thank you, sir. Hey, dear, you're 5 minutes late, honey.
You're very lucky. I've kept others waiting for days.
Well, anytime you want to go back to those others. Perfectly all right with me.
My best friend gets hit by a streetcar, winds up in the hospital, civil war in Spain, and earthquakes in Japan, and now you wear that hat.
What's the matter with his hat?
It embarrasses me.
Embarrasses you?
Yeah. I had it on.
Well, where if I like it and I like it? What shall we eat?
We'll go to the Ritz.
We're not going to the Ritz. We're going someplace that fits our purse.
Sweetheart, this is a celebration.
We're not going to the Ritz.
A fine way to talk to the chief deputy.
We're not going to the Ritz.
For the first time since I've known you, you're going to do as I say. We're going to the Ritz.
thing. Maybe a chief of weights and measures. Pushing a tray.
Are you skipping that spinach?
I certainly am.
Another portion, please.
Fine way to talk to the chief deputy. Say, would you care for some nice spinach, chief deputy?
What are you mumbling about? Pot roast.
The old green's in the hospital.
No.
Yeah, automobile accident.
Oh, that's too bad. Anything serious?
Serious enough to keep him there for several weeks.
Oh, I'll have to send him some. Well, that puts you in charge.
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me?
Well, I just want to get her out of the convention.
Jello.
No jello, apple pie.
No apple pie. Jello.
Lunch at the Ritz. It's so much more social to eat. That's very social.
I put your money in the bank yesterday, sir.
Huh?
Uh-huh. I'm surprised. I picked out the winning thing. Just a plain gold bed, but it's lovely.
I've got my eye on a spoiled spider. It'll set us back on
the air. Just the bedroom set and all the kitchen furnishings. No, we can't afford it, Johnny. I'll wait.
Now, since you're making your own decisions, why do you want to make the leap?
I've been thinking about that, too. What do you say? Three weeks from Saturday.
3 weeks from Saturday? That's two more paydays. We'll be in swell shape.
Aren't you glad I made you stay, John? Now we have enough to furnish a cozy little apartment. Follow the installment plan, but it's just open.
Installment plan? It's a racket.
With you, everything. Everybody's a burglar, everybody's a crook. You don't believe in philanthropy. You don't believe in public scrutiny. You don't even believe in men like Mr. Cagney.
Well, look, however, Mr. Cagney is, he's your hopeless.
Oh, Johnny, you're hopeless. What would you do if I said Joel Green was a dishonest man?
You say you were cockeyed. Mm. He's honest as the day is long.
Well, that's just the way I feel about Mr. Cagney. And I should know. I've been with him many years. I was with the firm years before he made me his private secretary.
All right.
Oh, Mr. Hanlon.
Yes, ma'am.
I wonder if I could have a little information for my private file.
Why, certainly.
Are you married?
Well, yes.
Any children? Oh, how silly.
Yes. I mean, do you want my number?
I've got your number.
You've got my...
Oh, Mr. Haley, I wonder if by any chance you happen to be going my way.
Well, which way are you going?
The only thing is, I live at 191st Street.
That's a very funny thing. Now, I'm going within two blocks of it.
Oh, fine. Will you hold my name?
Yeah.
Haley, that's such a lovely name. It has a certain ring to it.
Did I ever tell you the history of the Haley?
No.
You know, Charlemagne, the emperor of the whole West, he was the first Haley. And one of the kings of Ireland, he was a Haley. Do you know that I am the first son of the first son of the first son for 600 years straight down to...
Haley Selassie?
Yes.
There's 10 after 6 and we don't pay overtime.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
On time?
I'm always on time, except when...
Good night, Aloysius.
Don't be working too hard, Johnny. I always say a fellow isn't happy unless he enjoys his work. And the only way to enjoy your work is to do a very little of it. Except, of course, in a case where you have something to do which you can't put off. In which case, you can always quit your job because you say...
Good night, Aloysius. Good night, Hazel.
Good night.
Take good care of yourself.
Don't worry about her. She knows all the answers.
Sure, I do. If you'll stop talking long enough for me to use them.
John and Katie, weren't you?
Yeah.
I'm Marty Capt.
district leader of the 7th. I figured we ought to meet. We've got a lot of things in common.
Why don't you come in, Mr. Cavanaugh?
Just plain party to you, Johnny.
What can I do for you?
Not a thing, kid. Not a thing. I came over here to do something for you. How about coming into my club? Our organization can use young fellows like you.
No, thanks. I don't think the boss likes us to belong to political clubs.
Well, you've got your own future to look out for. Why, you might get to be a district leader like me.
I couldn't dress the club.
We'll fix it so you can afford to dress this way. Very nice. Okay? A friend of mine spoke to me about you. He thinks very highly of your ability.
That's fine.
Sit down. He asked me very particularly to do something for him. How about deputy leader at 200 a month? And that's just a start, you understand? Now listen, you can... Just a minute. What's on your mind? Well, I happen to have a summons here that you gave Evie in the Paradise Market. And you want me to forget? That's the idea. You do us something, and we'll cut you a nice little slice of cake.
No, thanks. I don't want some.
What are you being so noble about? Going around with a chip on your shoulder. Listen, this stuff is all unimportant. A grocer or a butcher charges a woman 3 or 4 cents more than she's supposed to pay. So what? She never misses it. Look, I'll show you what I mean. You got 3 pennies? Just to prove that they don't mean a thing. See? You've lost 3 pennies. You don't miss them, do you? Well, that all depends. I'll show you what I mean. See? You lost a hat. You don't miss it, do you? Now listen, Johnny. We can do things for you or to you. You mean you'll do to me what you did to Joe Green?
I'll take it easy.
Now listen. I'll tell you, eat on for anybody who threatens my bed or try to spend money on my desk pocket. It's a one-way street, Cavanaugh. And if you start up, you're going to meet me coming down.
Let them have it, boys. You couldn't miss it for reason.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going your way. No, he ain't. He's going our way.
That's right.
Well, what are we waiting for? Come on, let's get it over with.
We can sit here and think. Try thinking, Red.
Are you trying to commit suicide?
You don't mind if I stretch, do you?
Fred, that ain't for us. That's for some hoodwits breaking the law.
11 even. Come on, we roll.
I don't like that penny on you.
Put this little lump on.
For what?
Put it on.
Who told you guys to do all this?
A little boy, kid. The boy.
always plan for you this spring. Get in there.
Johnny, in a way, it's your own fault. That chip on the shoulder comes. Now, you can't go around stepping on people's toes expecting to like it. You're too aggressive. That Irish.
What's the matter with the Irish?
I didn't say anything was the matter with the Irish.
You did, too.
I didn't. There you go, scrapping at the first opportunity. There's no sense in trying to be nice to you. Let me tell you something, Johnny. If you don't want to listen...
May I call your attention to this charming love scene?
Look, darling. I've got to be at the mayor's office in about 5 minutes. If you've got anything you like, I'm sure to get me something I can put my feet on. Bye.
What have you got for feet?
A footstool.
Cave is waiting for you.
Oh, fine. Don't let anyone disturb me, Helen. Oh, Mr. Cave. I'm glad you came. I've good news for you. Mr. Cave, I want to congratulate you on your record. As you met with the Department of Weights and Measures, your name has become a synonym for honesty. last year shows an increase of 53% in the number of arrests. I ascribe such a showing to your untiring efforts.
Superb.
Colossal. Precisely. Now, we wish to reward you properly in appointing you to the Governor's Tax Commission as Special Investigator. The appointment carries a salary almost double your present.
That's very nice, Your Honor, but you see, I...
Now, as a much older man, one who's devoted most of his life to the service of the Commonwealth, I advise you to accept. We have great need of a man of your caliber, Mr. Cave, in the Tax Commission. Great need. As has often been said, necessity is
the mother of suspension.
Liberty, Mr. Cave. All it takes, I think.
No, Your Honor. I'm very grateful for this opportunity, but I can't take it at this time.
I'm afraid this position can't wait.
Oh, what the use of trying to be subtle? I should be myself. Now, look. I'm staying in the department, and there's not going to be any fix. I know I'm treading a lot of toes in this organization. I also know that the boys want me out of the way.
That's a bold statement, Mr. Camp. I'm sure you don't mean it.
I mean it. You can tell Mr. Marty Cavanaugh, who instructed you to call me, that I said so.
Are you suggesting that Mr. Cavanaugh dictates the policy of this office?
What do you think?
Cagney on the phone. Yeah. Uh-huh. Arrogant, swell-headed troublemaker. Definitely dangerous. Must be stopped.
Never mind. We'll find a way.
How about 18 holes in the morning?
Right.
A sudden notice of my removal always came as a great shock. It leaves me with a very helpless feeling after all my years of service.
I'm afraid you objected a bit too strenuously, Mrs. Ogilvie.
Mr. Cave, we were being cheated. And for a long time, the deliveries were always far short of what we were compelled to sign
for. Yes, I think that every component, as far as beaches are concerned, I'm here to live for that.
Yes, I got it. Hey, will you take this? Oh, you sure don't. As if it wasn't coming to ten.
There seems to be a bit of a difference, Mrs. Ogilvie, between the items received for and those delivered. At least 50%.
Of course. There always is.
Why'd you decide this?
Not me, sir. Just want to get my job.
The sign would give you a chance to think it over in a cage. It goes for you, too. Don't sign with an X.
Hi, Marty.
Johnny, what are you doing here?
Just trying to make a call.
Office hours, you know better than that.
Well, I'm working with you with a guy that's in love. I want to get a look at you.
What happened at the mayor's office?
Offer me a job. On the government staff, what's more to do?
Johnny, how wonderful.
Oh,
Johnny Cagney, you're not going to pass up an opportunity like that. Sounds like your real chance. Like what it means to you. What?
Fine, Cagney.
Red Cagney, you old palooka! I ain't put a lamp on you since we fought those 15 rounds in Jersey City.
Glad to see you, Pete. Hey, getting kind of soft, aren't you? Oh, I've been taking it easy. I'm going to take it even easier. You know, I saw my Brophy's in bookplace. Don't see some stock manipulators. They don't make theirs running the stock up and down. That dirty crooks. What are you doing here? I come up to get a passport. I'm going to England.
I'm going to play one of them dukes and the ritzy dolls. You know, drink tea and chase boxes. Why do they chase boxes?
It's supposed to be sport.
And I'm going to skip. I'm going to be a sport. I'm going to be a gentleman. I got 3 million stacks of cash, man. 100 different names in 22 banks.
Well, what's Kenny got to do with it? Sending it to his bootmaker?
Bootmaker? Mm. Well, I want my boots. I ain't going waiting.
Oh, wait. You want to get a passport?
Yeah, Kenny fixed it for me. Nice, but fine grand. He really ought to count for nothing. Listen, Brad. The last 5 years I've paid Kenny and his mom $1 million fixed money. I ain't spoken. You understand? I want a protection. Give it to me.
Say, but I didn't know that Kenny did that kind of dough. And what do you call that?
Nah, nobody's going to jump him up, Brad.
But you never tell me. There's always that unnoticed banality.
Not him, Brad. What are you doing up here?
Well, Kenny's secretary's my girl. What do you mind?
Well, congratulations, you lucky stiff. Oh, Janet, watch me a friend of mine. This is Pete Riley. Used to be the leather business.
Yeah.
I used to give red samples. I'm pleased to meet you. Got the finest guy in shoes.
I think so.
Steve, I'm throwing a big party tonight at the Grillion. I got a whole floor there in the cage for the butlers. I want you both to come. Oh, it's going to be a swell blow up.
I'm going to fancy trimmers. I'm going to make a speech, too.
I wouldn't miss that. What do you say, Ellen?
Thank you, Mr. Riley. We'll be there.
Great. 9:30. So long, old palooka. Let's get to dinner. I got $1,000 worth of fancy grub coming.
He made a speech on the radio, man.
He spoke on the radio?
Yeah, he said, oh, Ma, who's going to fight him? Glad I won. I think it's only going to
happen. Oh, I'm glad you're not prize fighting anymore. Listen, Johnny, about that job for me.
We need something to
handle. You know I'll do anything I can.
Well, if I prove to you that this boss of yours is not the shining example of what you're supposed to be, would you do something for me?
Johnny, how can you suggest such a what's wrong with... Mr.
Canning,
this is Mr. Cave.
Mr. Cave, Department of Weights and Measures? Well, I'm delighted to meet you.
Thank you.
Will you come in?
That's nice.
I don't hold you up, Mr. Canning, if you want some place.
Not at all. Glad to have a chat with you.
Sit down.
Thanks. His Honor, Mayor, we played golf yesterday. You sort of put him in the spot with the governor.
Oh, really?
Yes, indeed. He promised the old boy he could deliver just the man he wanted, and well, you turned him down cold.
Oh, I'm sorry. I have some even plans.
I believe you make a big mistake. I've already experienced much made off of that. But of course, you can take it or leave it as you see fit. But I do believe you should give this opportunity further consideration. It is an opportunity, Mr. Cade, for the me, and one that might open the door, so to speak, to a busy branch of the chair. What do you say?
You really think I ought to do it?
I do indeed. Let me give the story of your chemistry papers.
Let me give it to him. Clarke congratulates Mr. Cagney on your kindness to charity. I heard about your latest gift. Oh, thanks. Murphy, please. Murphy? Johnny K. of your West Measures. Say, I've got a paper story we read in an edition. Huh? Well, here's your headline. Abel Canning steals bread from mouth of city's orphans. Collection supplies he never delivered. Send a couple men over to my office in about 20 minutes.
You wouldn't dare.
I've got to be going, Canning. Quick appointment.
You go through with that cave, you wish you never were born.
I'll see you in jail, bread snatcher.
How dare you talk like that to me?
Well, you hear the prosecuting attorney have to say to
me. Well, let's see, Johnny.
Keep out of this, will you? I'm giving you the affidavits this afternoon. So long.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Kennedy.
Don't be sorry for me. It's the young man who'll suffer. If he gives his blackmailing scheme to the papers, I'll...
No.
I won't have to do a thing. Public opinion will force him out of office. He'd be lucky if he escapes a jail sentence.
You don't know Mr. Canning like I do. He's a fine man. Well, he's done everything for me. Put me through business college, gave me this job. Well, he's been like a father to me. No, Johnny, you're mistaken. Well, don't do anything I can't forgive you for.
You won't have to forgive me for anything, baby. I know what I'm doing. I've got...
prosecutor's office speaking. Ask Johnny Cage to send down all the papers on the Canning case right away.
Just a moment, please. Mr. Cage, the prosecutor's office wants the evidence on the Canning case. Shall I take the papers down?
Shall I bring down the safe in a couple minutes?
Mr. Cage has to bring them down himself in about 2 minutes.
Thank you. Anyone here speaking back about that?
Nice work, Burton. Bring him over here right away.
Thinking things over, Mr. Canning. I'm in a bad pen. 500 ain't enough for them papers. They're worth a lot more to me. Oh, I should say about...
$5,000? $5,000? You weren't taking any chances. Not with me behind you. But you're taking chances now. Yeah? Well, get a load of this. I'm not going to hit one of them sudden accidents. Because I'll come and wait until the city prosecutor with the papers on. No, it doesn't interest me, Mr. Kennedy. It's $5,000 or I'll fill in papers someplace else.
Find anything yet, Pat? I gave all the description I could. Well, what happened so quickly? I'm not completely dizzy. Still dizzy. You do whatever you think best. As far as I'm concerned, you're the police department. You keep digging through those pictures and help me down for a while.
It's worse than that, Johnny.
What's this?
Your bank book. All your savings are there. But your department, not anymore.
Oh, now, darling, you don't mean...
I mean, we're through. Finished. Mr. Reese, listen, you've got to let me tell you the papers. I've written to enough. It's no use to you. You hurt me. I begged you not to. But you wouldn't listen. You never did. You're arrogant. You're stubborn. We could never be happy together. I love you, but I'm going to get over it. And you... Well, so...
I don't ever want to see you again. How about this guy?
No.
Here's a big baby. There's the guy, Pat. You're like a pop star. Mm.
Joe Burton, alias Belden, alias Bill Kowitz. Ex-wrestler, 4 convictions.
may be the answer to an Omen's prayer. Get to it. Will you come? Follow on, Tate.
Well, we got to get Charlie and Joe, a couple of pigeons, a car. Take all of 20 minutes. Charlie, listen. You haven't got a thing on me, Hanlon, and you know it. You've got a lot of cross pinching me and breaking the law. I could have you busted for this.
That's quite a pull, eh, Joe?
Yeah. Why? Let me use that phone, and I'll get sprung out of this trap in 5 minutes.
Plenty of time. Telephone girls will be out all night. You don't remember strong-arming this fellow this afternoon and stealing his papers.
I never monkey with kids.
Take it easy, Johnny. He and Talker will keep him here till Christmas. Hmm. 6 tickets for Marty Cavanaugh's political jamboree in the moonlight. Marty, a friend of yours?
Yeah, no way. What about it?
Nothing. Mike, take him downstairs a while. He's tired. He needs a little rest.
You can't do this to me, Hanlon. I tell you, I've got an important date.
Oh? Mike, on the way down, tell Mr. Burton the story of the lifer if they wanted to know what time it was. Go on. Let me see how much singing that canary did.
Yeah, so I know. Anyway, we've got an apartment address. I'll let you get a quick frisk.
I'm just coming to that. This is the only key here. Look at that. Mom must have given him that the tea, though.
Well, thanks, Pat.
Take it easy now, Johnny. I'll be sure to examine the drain pipe under the sink.
Can't fool me. I'll even look under his pillow.
Good luck.
There aren't going to be any ifs or buts about it. I want Joe Wagner released at once.
Well, I'll see what I can do about it.
You'll see about nothing. You'll do it.
Okay.
Roger, get me Captain Hanlon on the phone. Have you got anything on him anyway?
I let Burke go. Orders from the boss.
Oh, that's all right. I didn't want Burke. I want those papers.
Think Burton still had them?
Certainly, that's when they got him out of hand.
That's right. I'd like to give that mug another working over for the way he bawled me out in the bag. Said he hardly had time to get his map scraped and massaged. Going to that big blowout Pete Riley's given tonight.
Burton's going to Riley's party?
Said he has an invite.
So am I. I've just got time enough to get my third bag down myself.
I'm worth the kid.
Look out, Johnny. Burton's tough.
I found that out.
You're like, you should be dancing. I'm sitting here decorating the wall.
Thank you. I'm waiting for Mr. Parker. He'll be back. Won't you sit down?
Say, what's this really hard to give a white pal?
Mr. Reilly, I'm not giving anybody white pal. I'm just sitting here minding my own business.
I get it. You want me to mind mine? But this is my party, and I want everybody to be happy, especially you, Johnny.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd rather not discuss it. Besides, I don't think you'd understand.
It's my guess that you don't understand, Johnny. Don't you read the papers? This guy's in a jam. See all that beef on the book?
It wasn't a part of the jungle. With a hip parameter on this side, a leopard on the other, at me heels was a tiger, and right in front of me was a roaring lion. Well, I was in a pretty bad way.
But what happened?
I was killed.
Surprised to see you.
When you gave me the invitation, Pete, I thought you meant it.
Sure I did. You're as welcome as the flowers in July. Come on, I'll stick around and introduce you to the mob.
Oh, don't bother. I'll find my way about it.
Okay, find yourself a spot to dance with. I'll see you later. If you want a drink, flag a butler.
All right. May I see you a minute?
Yeah, sure. That's my bank account. Don't bother your nose, will you?
I'll be right back.
Oops. Have you hurt you?
No, but I have my dress.
You all right?
Yeah.
Nothing to it.
No. Hello, Mr. Cagney.
Janet.
I'd like you to know, Mr. Parker. This is my boss, Mr. Cagney.
Delighted, Mr. Parker. You're in very good company. I agree with you.
Thank you. Wait a minute.
Say, what happened to that big mug? Did it fall on the floor?
Don't mean that guy that's been marching up and down my heels all week, do you?
Yeah. See him?
Well, not lately.
You can't scare me, Kenny. It's $5,000 or no papers, and that's fine.
Now hold it up.
Yeah?
What did you call that? Could you have me?
You don't think I carry $5,000 around in my pocket?
I'll take a check made out of cash for the key to my apartment. That'll make it a legitimate. Hey, do you mind when you get in?
No, I'll
go. Did you find him in that area?
I'll find him, all right. I'll just take a ride and I'll find him. It's nutty.
See you then.
Let me go up first.
Look at nice thing. Right there. I left with a left. Oh, no, Pete. I left with a left. With a right. I'll show you. I left.
I went a left, and you brought in a left, and I threw a right hand and missed. Get back, give me some air. Get this guy some water, will you, please? Now, where's that water? We've got a shot of scotch. One for me, too.
That's right.
You take care of it, will you, Alex? Explain them how it happened. I'll see you later.
Making comparisons here. My father always said you've got to know something about the weeds to appreciate the rose.
Mm. Well, let's get out of the garden and pay some attention to me.
Oh, yes.
I was simply telling the girl about watching her. Excuse us.
Listen, you keep your eye on Britain. Tell my father and Marty here. I'm going over to Britain the father. Tell him you're
here. Yeah, explain that.
Excuse me.
What's your name?
I beg your pardon. You're a friend of Johnny Cage's.
I'm proud of him. Aren't you the girl he's come to marry?
I hope so.
Well, you're with Johnny, then, well, you might be affected.
Has he gone out?
No, he's gone out looking for a better truth. He has a date with Mr. Cagney at Mr. Bertrand's apartment. Which reminds me, I have a date with Mr. Burke.
Excuse me.
Come on.
Get money out of here.
Johnny wants Mr. Burke to wait from here, Mr. Reilly. It's very important.
Oh, yeah? You think you're big enough to kill me? Of course, you're staying right here. See you at the break and doesn't leave the party. I want him to stay and enjoy himself.
That's it.
Well, all right, come on, folks. Step up. Let's have some today. Quick.
Hello, police headquarters. And let me speak to Mr. Hanlon, please. Oh, well, Captain Hanlon, then. Just say a friend of Johnny Cage's.
Keep an eye on the door.
Wouldn't it be just too bad if you were found here stiff and cold, shot while committing burglary?
You haven't got time enough to use that rod on me, Cavanaugh.
Funny, I thought I had.
Take care of him. The last one to get rid of these.
off the party with that Reilly. Oh, Marty. And without a permit. Mike, I'm afraid we'll have to arrest Mr. Cavanaugh.
I'm afraid so.
Firebug in a high hat.
Everything all right, Johnny?
Yeah. Kind of toasted around the edges, but it's all here.
I'm afraid we'll have to arrest you for, what'll it be, Johnny?
Oh, $10.
Well, that'll do for now.
You can't arrest me. Let me have that phone.
Oh, no, it wouldn't be fair to Mr. Burton. He'd have to pay for the call. I send a man to pick him up. I think we'll have a little get-together, and Pete Riley may send some sandwiches. Take good care of Mr. Canning, Mike. And don't bend him. Well, let's get going. Come on, Marty.
See you in a minute. Let me out of here.
Open that door, Johnny.
Now you're going to get what's coming to me.
You can't hit me. I'm under arrest.
Oh, no.
Come on, Johnny. Open this door. Open this door. You can't beat up my prisoner.
You
didn't use the money we'd saved.
Oh, of course not. Yeah. Give yourself. It's all intact.
And how did you get the ring?
Bought it, of course.
But how?
On the installment plan.
But what about...
I know. It's a racket.
But Johnny...
Call your attention to this charming love scene.